Okay, so I'll wait lang for one of your classmates to log in. May nag-pop up kaya na may matatanggal na iba before mag-start recording. Okay, so I'll be discussing introduction to inferential analysis. So we're almost done with descriptive part. So in the introductory part of the inferential analysis, it's important for us to understand how we understand some of the basic terms, technical terms in the conduct of tests of hypotheses. Okay. Wait lang. Faye yung kafe? O na, what? I'm not sure. Check ko lang kung yung si Faye. Esperanza. Faye. Wait lang. I-ano ko lang siya. Sige, check ko lang si Miss Fe Esperanza kung yaon na siya dito sa laog. Mayo pa. Sige, I'll check. Ayan. Oh, sige, yaon. Hindi siya nagtataram, Fe. Okay, sige. Let's start.
Join ko lang po.
Ah, sige, sige. Ah, okay, sige, sige. Okay. Okay. Okay, ayan. So, yun na-mention ko kanina, di ba? Sa introductory part, it's important that we know how to formulate your null and alternative hypotheses. Bakit? Kasi when you run your data sa any statistical methods, usually, the conclusion will be based, the final conclusion will be based on the hypothesis that you have formulated. So, ano ba yung hypothesis na yun? Okay. So, in deciding the appropriate statistical test to be used in data analysis, we consider the following. Okay, so kunwari meron na kayong tallied data, di ba? And then, of course, you have already the objectives of your study. The next, usually when you do your methodology, you decide, ano ba yung appropriate statistical test na gagamitin ko given these objectives of the study? Okay, for you to be able to do that, okay, we should know the following. First, dapat meron tayong knowledge, ano ba yung levels of measurement? Okay, so we have discussed that already, di ba? You have the nominal, ordinal, interval, and the ratio. You should know the test for normality of data. I don't know if I have mentioned this in my other class, but in the normality of data, we have three tests that we can use, di ba? You have your Kolmogorov, you have your Anderson, and then you have your Shapiro. Okay, so to distinguish this from each other, yung Shapiro, ginagamit natin siya if your sample size is less than 30. And then the other two is used when your sample size is greater than 30. Okay, so we determine the scales of measurement. Second, we determine the normality of data. And then the third one, we examine the objectives of the study. Okay, so once we have these three, then we can decide, ano ba yung gagamitin ko? Magpa-parametric ba ako? Magna-non-parametric ako? Magko-correlation ba ako? Kung parametric test ang gagamitin ko, magti-t-test ba ako? Z-test or F-test? Okay. Ayan. So, this is just a... Yan. Parang overview kung paano natin ginagawa ang analysis. So, first step, ito, we determine the level or scales of measurement. After we determine the scales of measurement, we subject the data to test of normality. So, any of the three. Okay? So, pag ang data natin is interval and ratio and normally distributed, then we use the parametric methods. Otherwise, kung nominal lang siya or ordinal or qualitative, then, and of course, if your data is non-normal, then we use the non-parametric. Okay, ining mga parametric methods na nining z-test, t-test, f-test, meron siya mga counterpart dun sa non-parametric methods. Okay, so sorry, I have to stop kasi merong nagpapa-admit. Okay, yeah. So this is the problem with Google Meet kasi. Okay, so hopefully wala nang pumasok. Okay, so I'll continue. Okay, sige. Admit ko na lang siya dito sa cellphone ko. Okay, so I'll continue. Okay, and then I'll discuss later kung ano-ano yung mga commonly used parametric methods. Okay? Ayan. Okay, so yung third na kino-consider natin in deciding what statistical tool is we consider the objectives. So usually, yung mga common objectives natin, specifically if this will be an application of the inferential statistics, usually, ang objectives umiikot lang dito sa tatlo. It's either you determine differences of variables among groups of different groups, you determine relationship, or you determine impact, effect, or influence. Okay, so dito sa upper part, makikita natin, pag ang kino-compare daw natin, ang data natin is either nominal or ordinal, and then we're comparing two or more groups of data. Sa differences, if your objectives is to determine significant differences, okay, ganyan, we have these different statistical tools under Z-test 1 proportion, Z-test 2 proportions, chi-square goodness of fit, chi-square test of independence. If you're determining relationship naman, among two or more groups of data that are either nominal or ordinal, again, we have these different statistical tools. We have this chi-square test of independence, Fisher's exact test, the Spearman correlation, gamma phi by serial correlation. And since we are considering here nominal or ordinal data, so these are qualitative data, usually when you determine impact or effect, ang commonly used na data analysis for that is, kasi hindi siya statistical test, this is qualitative data analysis, is either you conduct the FGD or focus group discussion, triangulation, or the SWOT analysis. Okay? And then dito naman sa lower part, this time, quantitative na ang data natin. Okay? So if you're comparing two sets of data, and then your objective is to determine significant differences, you have here the Z-test, T-test, Mann-Whitney, or the Wilcoxon sign. And then if you have three or more, you have the ANOMA, Friedman, Kruskal-Wallis. So later on, i-mention ko siya ulit. And then if you're determining relationship or association, again, if you're comparing two groups of data, you either use Pearson correlation or the point by serial. If you are determining relationship of three or more groups of data, we apply the multiple correlation. And then yung pinaka-basic lang na regression, if you're determining impact, influence, factors affecting a particular variable, ito yun may mga dependent sa independent variable na tayo. If you're comparing two groups of data, we apply the simple linear regression, or in other term, you call this the ordinary least square. And then if you have more than one independent variables, we apply the multiple regression. Ayan. Okay, so this is the 9 parametric methods na hindi po natin ito i-discuss lahat. So we're going to focus on number 2, 6, 7, and 8. Okay, so these are the commonly used statistical parametric methods. Okay, so I have to wait down. Okay, so I'll just admit the class dito sa cellphone ko para hindi tayo ma-interrupt. Wait lang. Okay, sorry ha. I need to stop. Okay, yan. Next time kasi, sana pasok tayo ng maaga para hindi po na-interrupt yung class. Okay, so I'll go back. Ayan. Okay. Okay, ayan. So, ano yung sabi ko? Okay, so we focus on t-test number 2, t-test 1 sample, although not much on this. More on number 6, 7, and 8. So, t-test independent, t-test dependent, and then one factor, ANOVA one way. Okay. Okay, so Ayan. So, na-mention ko na to kanina, we categorize our statistical tools or tests into three. We have parametric, non-parametric, and correlational. Again, these are the commonly used statistical tests. Okay? So, under parametric, you have z-test, t-test, and then the f-test. And then, may mga counterparts po yan sa non-parametric. Correlational naman, this specifically, we use this one in determining relationship. Ang parametric po sa non-parametric, usually they are used to determine test of differences among groups of data. Okay, so again, we go back in sa discussion natin ng numerical descriptive methods. Anong implication if your data is normally distributed? Okay, wala tayong extreme value. In case there are extreme values, they may be very few and the presence of it do not affect the mean. Among the measures of central tendency, we use the mean to interpret your data. Kasi nga wala tayong outliers. Pag may outliers tayo, naaapektuhan yung mean niya. So pag normally distributed ang data, the most appropriate statistical central tendency to use is the mean. And then the normality of data leads to the use of parametric methods. If your data is normally distributed, we have another assumption check kasi pag gumagamit tayo ng parametric, hindi lang normality of data, chine-check din natin homogeneity of variances. So pag normally distributed daw ang data, we use the Bartlett's test for homogeneity of variances. Again, I will be mentioning this ulit pag nag-start na tayo ng test of hypotheses. Okay, so if data is not normal, non-parametric methods are used and Levine's test is used for homogeneity of variances. Okay, so these are the three tests of normality. So it's actually the Shapiro-Wilk that we will be using using Jamovi. Okay, so dito, our decision rule would be if the p-value is greater than or if 0.05 is less than the p-value, then the data is normally distributed. Otherwise, it is not normal. Okay, so na-mention ko na to kanina. We can skip this. Okay, so I've mentioned this a while ago na rin. Okay, ito po yung mga counterparts ng non-parametric sa parametric. So, ulitin ko lang, ang parametric methods ginagamit natin if your data is normally distributed and if it's quantitative. Okay, pag hindi siya normally distributed or pag ang data natin is ordinal, we use the counterpart, the non-parametric counterpart. So, if you're determining differences of two independent groups, we use the Wilcoxon sign test and then if you're determining the differences of two dependent groups, you use the non-parametric counterparts will be this one, Wilcoxon, Mann, Whitney. Three or more groups, we use the Kruskal-Wallis. And in terms of correlation, we use the Spearman. Okay, so let's start. So whenever you do data analysis, we have these steps of test of hypothesis. So usually, anong meron sa test of hypothesis? So it will always start with formulating your HO and your HA. Ano ba yung HO saka HA? So if you look at the different steps of your test of hypothesis, we actually have 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 steps in conducting the test of hypothesis. Ini pong naka-red one, standard na po yan. Ibig sabihin yung kaya, in all hypothesis testing, there's only one decision rule. So we reject HO if the computed value is greater than the tabulated or critical value, or another basis is comparing the level of significance with the p-value. So if the level of significance is greater than the p-value, then we reject HO. And then sa computation na part, again, we will not be doing the computation manually kasi we have the software. So all we have to do is just input the data and then lalabas na doon yung computed or tabulated. Or if you will be using the Jamovi, lalabas na doon yung p-value. And then from the result of your values, your computation, we decide, do we reject or accept your HO? And then we do the necessary conclusion. Okay, so lahat po yan ituturo ko sa inyo. Ayan, so ano pa yung ibig sabihin ng HO saka HA? Okay, so usually, your HO, this is read as if you're spelling it out. So you don't read it as HO. Okay, that's the null hypothesis. Usually, it shows non-significance of differences, non-significance of relationship. So if you're comparing two groups of data, let's say performance of section A and B, sabi dito, non-significance of difference, ibig sabihin, equal lang ang performance ng dalawa. So palaging equal ang dalawa. Okay? Pag alternative or research hypothesis naman, that is your HA, again, you don't read that as HA, This is the research hypothesis. This is the hypothesis which this is the result that the researcher wished to is expecting to happen. Okay? So it's either, for example, you're comparing two methods. Pwedeng may difference si dalawang method. There is significant difference between A and B. Or pwede naman A is significantly greater than B. Or pwede naman A is significantly less than B. Or B is greater than A. Okay? So depende yan dun sa problem. Depende sa ikiklaim ng researcher. Okay? So we have three possible alternative hypotheses. Pwedeng not equal, pwedeng greater than, pwedeng less than. Okay, so pag sinabi naman, another terms to define is the difference between the one-tailed and the two-tailed test. Pag sinabi natin one-tailed test, that means if the researcher claims a certain group or variable is greater than or less than the other. Okay, wait, I'll get my whiteboard. Wait lang. Okay. Okay, so pag one-tailed, okay, how will we decide, how will we know kung one-tailed or two-tailed? Depende po yan kung ano ang alternative hypothesis natin, kung ano yung HA. Okay, kung not equal ba, greater than ba, or less than. Pag ang alternative hypothesis po natin is either greater than or less than, that is a one-tailed test. Okay, one-tailed test po yan. Okay, ito. And either greater than or less than. So example, students in the morning classes perform better in mathematics than students in the afternoon class. So may mas higit na other group of respondents. The machine produces capsules with dosage greater than 50 milligrams. So ito yung mga keywords natin to determine a one-tailed test. And then the amount of weight loss for low-carb diet is lower or lesser than that of low-fat diet. Okay, so that is a one-tailed test. Pag two-tailed test naman, ang alternative hypothesis natin is not equal. So if the researcher claims that the two groups of data or variables are different or not equal. Okay, example, there is difference, okay, between the size of the leaves growing in full sunlight and those growing in shade. So walang naka-specify na this group is better than the other one. Sinabi niya lang na not equal yung dalawa or may difference. So dito naman, meron tayong data set and then sabi dito, do this data provide sufficient evidence that the sample mean is not equal to 12 ml? Okay, ito po yung keyword natin. And then, the recovery period of knee surgery patients undergoing physical therapy twice a week is not equal. Okay, so again, pag nakita natin yan, it will fall under the two-tailed test. Bakit importante to? Kasi pag nag-conduct po tayo ng test of hypothesis, nagbabago yung critical value, yung isa sa mga basis natin for deciding if it's accept or reject, nagbabago ang value niya pag yung problem natin is two-tailed and pag naka-one-tailed siya. Okay, so let's, so importante yung pag-decide natin kung ano ba yung problem natin, one-tailed and two-tailed. And of course, paano yung pag-formulate ng null sa alternative. So I have three examples lang dito. I provided this as a reading material. So hopefully, napag-aralan nyo na rin ng konti. Okay, so a professor wants to know if the average grade in algebra of freshman college students who studied in high school and in the USA is significantly different from their counterparts who had their high school education in the Philippines. Okay? So sabi natin, di ba, how will I start with the formulation of H and HA? Alamin nyo muna, ano ba yung mini-measure dun sa problem? Okay, so for this particular problem, ano yung mini-measure niya? Sige, anyone? Ano yung basis for
average?
Sige.
Average.
Okay, it's the average grade. So, alamin nyo muna ano yung mini-measure and then ano yung dalawang group na kino-compare. Okay, so these are college students na nasa US, tapos college students sa counterpart niya sa Philippines. Okay, so sabi natin, di ba, pag null hypothesis, palagi siyang equal. So the average grades in algebra in USA is the same with their counterparts with high school education in the Philippines. Actually, you can make this shorter. Okay? Of course, our alternative would be, so take note of the alternative hypothesis na sinabi. It's different. Okay? Kasi, ang kiniklaim naman dito sa problem is you want to, a professor wants to know if they are significantly different. So therefore, ganun din ang alternative hypothesis natin. Okay? So since different, wala naka-specify kung mas magaling ba yung USA o Philippines. Wala. Sinabi lang na magkaiba yung dalawa. Then you have a two-tailed test. Okay? Next, a teacher wants to know if listening to classical music will improve the performance of pupils. A previous study revealed an average score of 82. Actually, dito sa problem na to, you can have two null hypotheses. Okay, so correspondingly, dalawa din pwede nating maging alternative hypothesis. So for your null hypothesis, okay, so classical music will not improve performance of students. Kasi nga, di ba, pag null hypothesis, non-significance of relationship. Okay, or you may state it as the average score of the pupils is not different from 82. Kasi ang gustong i-imply nun, pag hindi naman siya different from 82, is that wala naman improvement sa performance. You can have either this, the first statement, or the other one. Okay, sabi dito, di ba, a teacher wants to know if listening to classical music will improve. So this will be your hint, okay, na ang alternative natin would be, okay, it's either classical music will improve performance of students or the average score of the pupils is higher. Bakit higher? Kasi nga, because of this keyword na improve. Yun ang gusto niyang i-imply. Mas mataas na dun sa average score na 82. So, since naka-specify yung direction natin na mas mataas, okay, then we have a one-tailed test. Okay? Next. In a graduate college, the average length of registration time during a semester is 120 minutes. A teacher wants to know, okay, if the introduction of the new registration procedure will make the process more efficient. Again, for this particular problem, pwede tayong magkaroon ng dalawang null hypothesis. First, the average length of registration time is not different or pwede is equal to 120 minutes. So, pag equal lang siya sa 120 minutes, ang gusto nang i-imply is that the new procedure is not efficient kasi wala naman palang nagbago dun sa length of registration time. Okay? Ayan. So, alternative would be the average length of registration time is different. Ay, hindi. Sige, ano magiging alternative natin? Is it different, greater than, or less than 120 minutes?
Less than 120 minutes.
Less than. Okay, sige po. Bakit po less than 120 minutes? Sige, anyone, yun na lang pong guy na nagsagot na una. Sige, introduce first yourself po.
Hello po, I am Alfonso po. Bragais, ma'am.
Okay, Sir Bragais.
Kasi dito, ma'am, ina-expect nila to make the process more efficient. And mas, ano. Kaya, I think, yun. Less okay, than po.
Opo. Kasi pag sinabi natin efficient, you can finish the task in lesser time. Okay. So, less than 120 minutes na siya. Okay. So, pag less than, okay, you have a one-tailed test ulit. Ayan. Sige, dalawa lang naman to. Okay. So, for example, we have this one. A company that produces herbal tea wants to know if their new product is an effective weight reducing agent. After the weight of 100 people were taken, they were given the new thing to drink twice a day and then after a month their weight were taken. Sige, anybody po? Hindi na po pwedeng sumagot si Mr. Bragais kasi nakasagot na siya. Okay lang po sir ha? Iba naman po. Sige, anybody from the class? Sige, again, dito sa problem na to, you can actually have two null hypotheses. Pwede kayong kumuha ng idea dun sa mismong statement. Sige, you may want to analyze first the problem. Sige, anyone? Okay, what's our null hypothesis? For example, you want to derive your null hypothesis from the first statement. Okay, siguro I'll call in Miss Cyrene Belga. Yung mga nagpadala sa akin ng picture, kaya natawagin ko. Ay, may nagla-login ulit. Wait lang. Sige, pag-isipan nyo muna. What will be our... Okay, sige, may pumapasok pa. Mga latecomers. Ayan. Sige, what will be our null hypothesis for the problem? Okay, so I'll share it again. Sige, yung mga nakapag-submit na sa akin ng activity. Kasi yung sa Ateneo, may pinasubmit ako. Ah, sige, Miss. Sige po. Miss Garrido. Wait lang po. Ayan po. Sige, Ma'am Cindy, ano pong pwede natin na null hypothesis? Yes, anyone? Hi. Ah, sige, si Ma'am Agnes. Sige po, Ma'am Agnes. Pasagot po.
Ma'am, try lang po.
Okay.
Ang narinig ko po dyan is, yung sa second statement po, the weight of 100 people is the same after drinking the new herbal.
Yan. Okay, so that's correct, Ma'am. That's correct. Okay, and then what will be our alternative hypothesis?
My alternative hypothesis, the weight of 100 people is not the same after drinking the new herbal tea.
Okay, so magko-comment po ako. Ano? Ang null hypothesis natin tama, okay? The same lang yung weight nila after taking the herbal tea. Pero ang alternative natin dito, kasi sabi po kasi dito, in-assume dito na effective weight reducing agent. So, ang alternative hypothesis po natin dyan would be the weight after would be less than na or pwedeng nag-reduce significantly. Kasi because of the word effective, ang gustong i-imply ng effective weight reducing agent is that there will be a decrease or pwedeng mas nag-lesser na yung weight niya after compared with the weight before. Okay po? So, hindi po not the same. Hindi po siya two-tailed. It's actually one-tailed test. Okay, so nag-reduce ang weight niya after. Pag ang H or HA naman natin will be based on the first one, pwede natin sabihin na hindi effective yun new herbal tea. Okay, hindi effective. That's your HO. And then HA would be the new product is an effective weight reducing agent. As simple as that. Okay, so you can actually have two HOs for this particular problem. And correspondingly, dalawa rin yung alternative hypothesis niya. And again, we have a one-tailed test. Okay, so the next one, an urn contains marbles which are either red or blue. We wish to test if there is a greater proportion of red marbles. So very easy lang po ito. Last problem ko na po ito before we proceed with the parametric method. Sige, anyone? What will be our HO here? Anong HO? And what do we have? One-tailed or two-tailed test? Sige po, anyone can answer. Pero hindi na po pwede mag-answer si... Si Miss Agnes ba yung sumagot kanina? Tama ba? O si Miss Garrido po?
Nito.
Sino
ka?
Ma'am
Agnes.
Okay. Si Ma'am Agnes saka si Sir na Bragay. So, iba naman po. Iba naman ang sasagot sa atin. Sige. I'll just call in. Sige, let us have, can we have Miss Myla? What will be our HO here, Miss Myla Palima?
Hello.
Yes po, sige.
Hello, ma'am. Good morning. Good afternoon po.
Sige, good afternoon.
This is Ms. Myla po. For null hypothesis, I think that would be the number of marbles are the same.
Okay.
And then for alternative...
Sige, kompleto po natin.
Ay, sige po.
Sige po. Mapapalaban ang English mo dyan.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. The number of marbles in the urn, ano ba to? Is either red or blue. Or yes nga po, parang ganun.
Hindi po. Sige, ulit. So, there is an equal proportion of...
Sige, okay. Yes,
patuloy mo na lang.
Since the parameter is proportion, tama po. So, the number of proportion, tama po ba?
Relax ka lang siyo. Kinakabahan kayo.
Yes po.
Okay, sige. An urn contains marbles which are either red or blue. We wish to test if there's a greater proportion of red marbles. Okay, so sabi natin, di ba, pag HO, palagi lang siyang equal. So, equal ang proportion of red and blue marbles. And then, alternative po natin is?
Greater than.
Okay, so there is a greater proportion of red marbles compared to blue marbles.
Thank you po.
Okay, so what do we have? One-tailed or two-tailed test?
One-tailed po.
Okay, so one tail test kasi naka-specify na mas greater ang red marbles. Okay? Ayan. So, it's important that we formulate correctly our HO saka HA. Basta pag HO, palagi siyang equal. And then pag alternative, depende dun sa problem. May mga keywords po tayo dyan that will imply an increase, decrease, or pwedeng not equal. Okay? Sige, let's continue. So, sabi natin kanina, in conducting test of hypothesis, standard lang yung decision rule. Okay? So, we have two bases for deciding kung reject or accept HO. It's either we compare the computed or the tabulated, okay? Or we compare the level of significance or your p-value. Ang level of significance po, minsan ang tawag natin dyan is the alpha. Okay? So, if you will be using the Jamovi, ang binibigay po ng Jamovi, nagbibigay ng ang Jamovi ng computed value at the same time ang p-value din. But in some statistical test, madalas ang binibigay nila is the p-value. Okay? So, this will be our decision rule. Okay. So, to interpret, pag sinabi natin reject HO, this implies significance in differences or relationship. And fail to reject HO or accept HO implies that the data has no evidence of the significance of difference, relationship, impacts, or effects. Yan. Kaya importante na tama si HO saka HA kasi this will be the basis of our conclusion. Okay, so we can skip this one. Basahin nyo na lang po yun nasa PowerPoint. Ayan, so we now discuss the different parametric methods. So in our discussion, magpo-focus lang po ako sa letter C, D, saka sa E kasi these are the commonly used parametric tests. Actually, we have 9. Okay, we have 9 pero we focus on these 3. Yung mga iba kasing higher, yung mga ANOVA, ang ANOVA po kasi, analysis of variance, 3 siya pero mostly, yung other 2 doon, those are used sa mga experimental design o kaya mga higher statistical analysis. Usually, yung mga papers ng mga MAED, umiikot po dito sa 3, sa t-test independent, t-test dependent, saka one factor ANOVA one way. Okay, so, stop ko ulit ang ano kasi po may pumasok na naman, may i-admit na naman ako. Okay, sorry ulit. Okay. Sino to? Mr. Rapinan. Okay, ayan. So, hindi na po ako magpapapasok pag may napumasok ulit kasi nai-interrupt po yung class natin. Kaya importante po na you log in before the time para hindi ma-interrupt ang discussion. Okay, sige, let's continue. Okay, so I'll discuss first the different features of this. Again, we focus on letter C, D, and E. Titis independent, titis dependent, then one factor, ANOVA 1. I-discuss ko muna po ang features and then may mga examples ako para ma-distinguish natin kung ano yung differences ng tatlo and kailan siya ina-apply. And then we go to the demo, the Jamovi part. Okay, so before we start, with applying the parametric test, kasi usually we decide po, ano, given the data, we decide, gagamit ba ako ng parametric or gagamit ako ng non-parametric? So may dalawa po tayong assumptions check. Kailangan i-run natin yung data, number one, sa normality of data, and then number two, sa homogeneity of variances. So ito muna pong dalawa, bago natin masabi na valid ang paggamit natin ng parametric test. Okay, so the first assumption would be the normality of data. So again, may tatlo tayo doon na options, may Shapiro and then the other two, the Kolmogorov and then the Ryan Anderson. Naka-default yung data natin, yung Jamovi natin sa Shapiro, pero okay lang naman, actually, well, maliit lang naman yung difference just in case Shapiro ang gamitin natin pag mas mataas sa sample size na 30. Okay? So ang decision rule natin dito, if p-value is greater than the level of significance, the data is normally distributed. So pag normally distributed siya, pwede tayong gumamit ng parametric methods. Okay? Usually, anong implication pag normally distributed ang data? So usually, ang ginagamit natin dyan for homogeneity of variances is the Bartlett's. Pag hindi po normally distributed ang data, ang gagamitin po natin dyan is the Levine's test. Okay? So we proceed to the next assumption. That is your homogeneity of variances. Again, the decision rule, pag mas mataas po yung p-value sa level of significance, the variances are equal. Okay? So ano ang implication nito pag equal ang variances? May mga options naman tayong makikita dun sa Jamovi. Pag equal ang variances, if we're comparing two groups of data, we use the t-test. Pag unequal, ang gagamitin po natin yung Welch t-test. So dalawang types po yung t-test natin. Isa for equal variances and then the other one is for unequal variances. Okay, so again, we skip this one kasi ayokong mabombard kayo ng napakarami statistical test. Pwede nyo lang itong basahin kasi may mga examples po ako dito para makita nyo yung difference. Pero again, we focus on this one. So we start with the t-test dependent sample. Okay, kailan natin gagamitin ng t-test dependent sample? So usually, we use this when we want to compare the differences of two dependent normally distributed data groups. Pag sinabi natin two dependent, okay, ito yung mga nagkakandak kayo ng pre-test, post-test, before and after. Okay, wherein parehas po ang respondents nindo. Okay, so since parehas ang respondents, ibig sabihin yung number two natin na features, ang sample size po niyan dapat parehas. Okay, and then usually po sa mga dependent na t-test dependent, minsan kaya may nagluluwas din na effect size. Okay, so ito additional information lang naman po ito, pero hindi naman siya ginagamit sa pag-interpret. Pero ang effect size, usually, point A, dinedetermine niya yung extent of effect of the intervention. Okay? So, kunwari, nag-pre and, di ba usually before we start, nagbibigay tayo ng diagnostic exam sa mga estudyante and then at the end of, let's say, the quarter or the sem, nagbibigay tayo ng post-test. Okay, to compare. Actually, ang tinetest natin dito, pag nag-compare kayo ng pre and post-test, is the intervention. Effective ba yung naging intervention or hindi? So, itong effect size actually explains the effect of the intervention in a dependent test or dependent samples. Okay, so again, ginagamit natin to pag may mga before and after, pre-test and post-test. Okay, so sample problem. So, yung mga sample problems ko po, ang iba dito walang data. So, para makita lang natin yung application ng t-test dependent. So, sabi dito sa sample problem, 10 experimental animals were subjected to conditions simulating disease. The number of heartbeats per minute before and after the experiment were recorded. So, do the data provide sufficient evidence to indicate that the experimental condition increases the number of heartbeats per minute? Okay? So, this is problem on before and after experiment. So again, we have the same set of respondents of subject of interest in this problem. So it falls under the t-test dependent sample. Another example would be this one. So the school director of FSSCR wants to determine if the grade point average of engineering college students decreases during the last semester of their junior years. A sample of 10 students is selected. So take note, we have the same set of students here. Kinumpare yung first semester and second semester nila. Okay, so again, this falls under the t-test dependent. Okay, so how do we interpret results of t-test dependent? Or paano ba natin, paano tayo nagkakandak ng test of hypothesis? So ganito po yung gagawin ninyo sa activity. Meron tayong data, may problem, and then you're going to conduct a complete test of hypothesis. And pag nag-conduct po tayo ng complete test of hypothesis, we always start with formulating our null and alternative. Okay? Okay. The school director, so again, we wants to determine the GPA of engineering college students decreases during the last semester of the junior year. A sample of 10 students is selected. Their GPAs for the first and second semesters of the junior years are as follows. Numerically, kung titingnan natin, di ba, from 90.30, bumaba siya ng 88.90. Pero pwede na ba tayo mag-conclude na bumaba siya? Nag-base lang tayo sa mean. Hindi. Bakit tayo hindi pwede mag-conclude? Kasi these are descriptive statistics. Ang descriptive statistics is not a valid basis, is not a basis for making conclusions. Dapat ma-prove natin statistically that the difference, that the decrease is significant. Pag ang decrease natin is significant, then that's the time you conclude na nag-decrease or pwedeng bumaba yung performance nila dun sa last semester. Okay? So we state our null and alternative. First, yeah, so there's no decrease in the grades during the last semester. Kasi nga, non-significance of relationship. And alternative would be there is a decrease. Bakit ito yung naging alternative natin? Kasi na-mention siya dun sa problem, di ba? Sabi dito, ito. Yan. So it follows na yun din ang alternative natin. So usually, yun pag-formulate natin ng alternative, makikita na rin naman natin yun dun sa problem. And usually may mga keywords naman siya. Okay. So, computed value, of course, the decision rule, hindi ko na nilalagay, but it's reject HO if computed is greater than the critical otherwise. Okay, wala akong nilagay. Anyway, so sabi dito, di ba, reject HO. If computed is greater than the critical or the tabulated value. Or if the level of significance or alpha na lang para mas madali. Or if alpha is greater than the p-value. Yan. Okay, the reject HO if computed is greater than the critical or if the level of significance is greater than the p-value. Otherwise, accept HO. So what will be our decision po dito? Do we reject or do we accept HO? Sige, anyone? Ano po? Do we reject or do we accept?
It's greater than.
Reject.
Magre-reject ba tayo?
Accept. Reject.
Okay, sabi dito ha, magre-reject tayo kung mas mataas. Yan. Kung mas mataas ang computed sa critical. Hindi naman po mas mataas ang computed sa critical. Diba, it's less than. 1.20 is less than. Diba? Tapos, ang level of significance, 0.05. Again, it's less than. The PIVA is not greater than. Therefore, we accept HO po. Very clear, diba? We reject HO if computed is greater than the critical. It's not greater than. 1.20 is not greater than. It's less than. Therefore, we accept HO. Okay. So, pag accept HO po, babalikan po tapos si HO sa kasi HA. Ibig sabihin, literally, ang conclusion ta will be your HO. Pero syempre, pag ginibuta si conclusion ta, medyo papagayon ta po ang statement. So, we always start with mentioning the level of significance. So, sabi kasi dito, ang ginamit na level of significance is this should be 0.01 kasi level, wait, we correct ha? It's not 0.05. Okay, sige. Okay, this should be 0.01 kasi 1% ang level of significance natin. Okay, we always mention the level of significance. So we start with at 1% level of significance, there is no decrease in the GPAs of the engineering students in the last semester of the junior. Thus, there's no enough evidence to conclude that their performance decreases during their last semester. Okay? So kahit na bumaba siya numerically, 'di ba, nalang 88.9 ay nagbaraba ng si performance. Dahil sabi statistically, there's no enough evidence na bumaba 'yun performance nila. Okay? So hindi ka pwedeng mag-conclude na there is a decrease during the last semester of their junior year. Okay? So again, we always start with your by mentioning their level of significance. Okay. So, anong gusto nyo i-imply ng 1% level of significance? Kasi, yung conclusion natin, class, nag-base lang naman tayo sa sample. So, it's not 100% accurate. So, your 1% level of significance implies na meron kang 1% probability of error, which is very, very small. Okay? Okay. So, this is t-test dependent. Okay. Ano naman ang t-test independent? Okay. Ang t-test independent, this time, you're comparing two independent groups. So, pag independent po, pwede yan magkaibaang, sample size nila. So, not necessarily the same. And of course, data is normally distributed. Okay, so example, kunwari nag-compare ka ng dalawang teaching strategies. Okay, records of midterm exams were obtained from two sections under different strategy. So sa method A, meron kang 30 students, sa method B, have 35. Okay, so if you want to compare that, obviously you have two quantitative data and in-assume naman dito na normally distributed ang data. Okay, so we apply the t-test independent. Another example would be, ito, nag-compare ng cholesterol measurements ng vegetarians and non-vegetarians. Okay? Notice na hindi po equal yung sample size na. Pero hindi naman lahat ng equal ang sample size is dependent. May mga cases naman tayo na pareho yung sample size, pero it falls under independent. Okay? So usually naman, di ba, ang keyword natin pag dependent is mga pre-test, post-test, before and after. Okay, so another example would be this one. You have the measurement of birth lengths of male and female infants in a small clinic give the following results. So you have the two groups, males saka females. Okay. Okay, sige, interpret natin ang results of t-test independent. So you wish to know if the cholesterol measurements from 10 vegetarians and 15 non-vegetarians are different. Okay? Null hypothesis would be the two groups, cholesterol measurement of the two groups are the same. Alternative would be they are different. Kasi yun naman ang in-assume dun sa problem. Okay? Yun ang in-assume. Hindi naman in-assume na pag vegetarian ka, mas mababa yung cholesterol mo. So, sinabi lang na yung dalawang group, different. Okay? Ayan. Okay, so, of course, pareho pa rin po yung decision rule natin. Reject HO if computed is greater than tabulated. Okay, so wala pong binigay dito na p-value. Sige, given this value po ng computed sa tabulated, what will be our decision, class? Do we reject or accept?
Accept po.
Okay. Accept po. Na yan. Very good. Kasi yung computed natin is less than the critical value. And then the conclusion, we say that at 5% level of significance, it can be concluded that the cholesterol measurement for the two groups are the same. Okay, kasi nga accept HO. So literally, your HO will be your conclusion. Pero yung statement natin, you always start by mentioning the level of significance. Okay. Okay, so let's go to the last parametric test. That is the one factor ANOVA one way. So medyo mahaba-haba lang to ng konti. Okay, sa one factor naman, palagi po class ha, pag t-test dependent or independent, palaging two groups of data. So this time naman, if you're comparing three or more groups of data, then you have the one factor ANOVA one way. Okay, in one of the conferences that I've attended, na-mention nila na ang one factor ANOVA one way is a regressional test. Okay, regressional test in such a way daw na usually kasi ang application talaga ng regression, pwedeng yung dalawang, yung independent saka dependent natin are both quantitative. But in this case, ang one factor ANOVA one way natin is ang dependent natin is quantitative pero ang independent is qualitative. Okay? So extension daw to ng regression. Okay, so one factor ANOVA 1, we sabi dito, okay, comparing 3 or more, equal standard. Assumption lang naman yung homogeneity of variances, pero in case na hindi naman siya homogeneous, pwede pa rin naman i-run ang one factor. Same with the t-test. Okay, pag nakita natin na may differences, yun, okay, sample, kung makita natin na may differences doon sa groups of data natin, then we perform the post hoc analysis. Okay? May kailangan po tayong i-perform pag nakita natin na may difference. Kasi, ang sinasagot lang naman ng one factor ANOVA one way, for example, we have this problem, ang sinasagot niya lang naman is, for example, in this given, sabi dito, di ba, determine the relative efficacies of 4 different medications. The length of time that the 4 different drugs provide relief from pain are as follows. So, may 4 groups of data tayo na kinompare. Pag ang lumabas sa ANOVA is may significant difference, sasabihin niya lang na may significant differences dun sa 4 groups of treatment. Pero, hindi niya specifically sasabihin, hindi niya specifically sinasabi kung ang drug A ba, significantly different ba siya sa drug D? Significantly different ba ang drug A sa drug B? Okay? So, hindi niya sinasabi kung aling pair doon ang may significant difference. That is why we proceed to the post hoc test. Kaya nga tinawag siyang post hoc kasi after the test, after performing the ANOVA, if it's significant, then we proceed to the post hoc. Pero kung ang result po ng ANOVA is wala naman significant difference, then there's no need to conduct the post hoc test. Okay? Okay, so this is another example. Mga pang-science kasi yung example ko, more on sa STEM. Pero hopefully po, mag-gets na naman natin. So this one naman, kinompare lang yung toxic materials among 3 different locations. Site 1, site 2, site 3. Again, pinapakita ko lang yung application ng ANOVA. ANOVA means analysis of variances. Kasi we have here 3 groups of data na. Okay, how do we do that? Ayan, post hoc test. May dalawa lang naman ako dito introduce yung 2 case. Ang 2 case po, meron nito ang Jamovi. Ang decision rule naman natin dito, medyo nakakalito ang decision rule, di ba? Kasi papalit-palit po. Pag mas mataas daw yung p-value sa... Mali. Wait lang. This is different. Sorry ha. I-re-resend ko po ang ano. I-re-resend ko ang PowerPoint. Pero this should be... Sige, parang hindi kayo malito. Kasi iba po ang decision rule pagdating doon sa test of normality saka homogeneity of variances. Duman po baliktad. Pag mas halangkaw ang p-value sa level of significance, normally distributed and equal ang variances respectively. Pero po sa ARUKIN, sa 2 case and sa pag-testing differences, ng relationship, pag mas mataas ang level of significance sa p-value, okay, may significant difference. Okay, sorry for the errors. Ayan. And I'll be introducing also the shift phase test, which is using another software. Okay, sige, interpret natin to. Okay, so for these 4 drugs, okay, drug A, B, C, and D, obviously, pwede tanang sabi yung kuta na si drug D ang pinaka-effective, di ba? Kasi 3 hours lang, rahay na, day na makulog, makaka-relieve na siya ng pain. Pero again, we have to run this sa statistical test para makita natin kung may significant difference ba. Okay? So our null hypothesis would be, okay, again, non-significance of differences, equal lang, okay? Equal lang ang length of pain relief sa 4 na medication. And then alternative, wala naman ditong in-specify na drug D is the most effective. Wala naman. Sinabi lang na i-test kung may differences. So the length of pain is different. So we have a two-tailed test. Ayan. Okay, so ang lumabas is this one. Computed is 12.5, tabulated is 3.49. Okay, very obvious, ano? Very obvious that computed is greater than tabulated. Therefore, we reject HO. So we interpret that as may significant differences on the length of pain relief among the 4 drugs. But hindi natin alam specifically kung alin doon yung pair na may significant difference. Kaya mag-proceed po tayo sa post hoc. So tuturuan ko naman kayo, madali lang naman po mag-interpret. Yung isa kasing software natin, may isa tayong software na madali lang makuha. Pareho din naman sa Jamovi. Okay, so itong software na to, using the SSB to, ito yung software na ginamit ko last time. Ito, makikita, yung may asterisk po, iyan itong pair na may difference. Okay, the rest, wala. So, between drug 1 and drug 2, may difference. Lagyan ko na lang ng arrow. Okay, between drug treatment 2 and treatment 3, may difference. And between treatment 2 and treatment 4. Okay, dito ko na lang ilagay. Yan. So, yan lang po ang pair na may difference. Okay? So, ano pong conclusion natin dyan pag ganyan ang result? Do you think drug D is the most effective? Sige, ang may difference lang is drug A and B, drug B and C, and drug B and D. Alin po sa apat ang pinaka-effective niyan? Okay, so given the result, ibig sabihin, ang drug A, drug C, halos parehas lang po ang result kayan, ang effectiveness kayan sa drug D. Ito pong 3 hours. Kasi wala naman po silang significant difference. Tingnan natin na, di ba, between T1 and T4, wala naman siyang significant difference. Kung naglast siya ng 3 hours saka 5 hours, parehas lang po yan. Okay? So, ang talagang may difference is the drug D. So, among the 4, least po ang, least effective ang drug B as in boy. Okay? So, we say that drug A and B implying A as more effective than B. B implying C as more effective than B. Ayan. Implying B, drug B and between B and D, mas effective ang drug D. Okay? Ayan. So that's how we interpret the post hoc test. Okay. Okay, so we can skip this one. So ito lang, we'll just discuss the non-parametric once na pagtapos na tayo sa parametric. Okay, sige po. Before I demo using the Jamovi, may questions po or clarification? Okay, sige po. Ayan. Sige, open ko muna yung cam ko. Sige, break muna po tayo kahit mga 3 minutes. Okay, 3 minutes break lang po. Mainom lang po akong tubig and mga CR. And then, pa-ready na po nung, paki-open na po ng Jamovi ninyo, and then paki-open na rin po nung data. Okay? Sige po. Okay, sige, siguro heart na lang na icon kung if you're still with me. Okay po. Sige. Okay, sige. 3 minutes po. Okay, thank you. Ayan. Okay na po na si updated na ano na si corrected na PowerPoint. Pick post ko na po. Okay, so ulitin ko lang ano, may pick share po akong link kang attendance. Pa-fill out na lang po kung di ipapunakan. Nasa may chat box lang. Anyway, si mga late pa lang, din hindi ito mahihiling. So, i-post ko po ulit. Kasi may 37 pa lang pong nag-fill out kang attendance. Nasa 60 plus na po kita. Wait lang. Send ko po ulit. Copy. Ayan. So, pick-post ko po si attendance na link. Pa-fill out na lang si mga di pa po nagsusurat. Okay. So, let's continue. Paki-open po ng Jamovi ninyo. And then, paki-open po nung data. Pag ang data po kaya nindo sa Excel, ay wait lang, share kita. Pag ang data po nito class sa Excel is, di siya previously naka-open, tapos ma-open ka mo ninyo movie, minsan, di niya na-i-import ang data. So, dapat, i-open nyo muna po yung Excel nyo. Kasi, for example, yung Excel nito, dako yung pa siyang sheets. Ano, di niya aram kayang kung anong si i-import niyang specific na data sheet. So, ang first step po nito kayan is, yan, open po nito si, ay, mali. Hindi to. Ito yung exercises ninyo. Okay. So, do we have the same data na po, class? Open nyo muna yung Excel nyo and then saka nyo po i-import sa Jamovi. So, nakakita po yung data ko, naka-Excel. We have the gender, region, types of behavior, behavioral score, social responsibility score. Okay na po?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, sige. Thank you. Okay, ini po, nagkataon lang po na ining behavioral score saka social responsibility. Bako siyang normally distributed. Pero i-assume ta na lang, ano, kasi i-demo ko man lang po digda ang parametric method. I-assume ta na lang na ininduwang quantitative data digdi is normally distributed. Okay, so naka-open na yung Excel. Open po natin yung Jamovi. Okay? Of course, the first step is to import the data. So, yung three lines sa upper left, open lang natin siya. Click open. And then browse kung saan nyo po sinave yun, pinadala kong data. Demo for parametric. Ayan. So, kung hindi man po makafollow, load na lang po kayo sa screen. Anyway, recorded naman po ito. Ayan. So, we have here the gender, the region, the types of behavior, a gender, male or female, region, if the respondent belongs to NCR, Central Luzon, and Calabar Zone, tatlong groups lang naman. Of course, gender, you have two. The types of behavior, kung end views, optimistic, trusting, and pessimistic, that's four group. And then, i-assume na lang po natin na itong behavioral sa social responsibility are normally distributed for parametric methods. Demo lang naman po. Ayan. First step, okay? I'll be demonstrating yung t-test natin. So, since may dalawang group lang naman tayo dito, the gender, male and female, what do you think would be the, suppose my objective is to determine the behavioral score, to determine the difference, if there's significant difference on the behavioral score between male and female, what do you think would be the appropriate statistical test for this? Are we going to apply t-test dependent or t-test independent?
It's independent.
Independent.
Kasi magkaiba yun, iba yung mga respondents natin sa male, iba yung respondents natin sa female. Okay, so first step natin is, okay, first step, i-check muna natin kung na-satisfy ba natin yung dalawang assumption, yung homogeneity of variances, saka test of normality. Pero again, dito nga sa test of normality, i-assume na muna natin na normally distributed. Pero sige, i-run pa rin natin yung data. So, sa upper left, click exploration, tapos descriptives. Okay, so i-run muna natin doon sa assumptions check yung quantitative data natin, which is for this particular demonstration, we're going to compare the behavioral score. So behavioral score, ipasok po natin doon sa variable. Tapos, click natin yung statistics. Hindi naman natin kailangan yung N, missing. Yan. Ang kailangan lang natin malaman kasi is yun Shapiro. Kung, again, maliit lang ang difference kung gagamit ka ng Andersen sa Kolmogorov. Pero makikita na, later po, pwede naman natin gamitan ng ibang option. Pero, for this data, wait lang. Pwede na tayong dumiretso para. Pwede na tayong dumiretso na sa t-test. Kasi meron naman doon test of normality. Okay, so independent sample t-test. Ayan. Okay, so dito sa independent sample t-test, una, ipapasok po natin sa dependent variable yun numerical data na i-compare natin. Okay, yun basis, yun variable na mini-measure. So that would be the behavioral score. Okay, pasok po natin sa dependent variable. Okay, next, grouping variable tayo. So since yung dalawang groups na i-compare po natin is gender, then we highlight gender, pasok natin sa grouping variable. Ayan. Okay, so dito, automatic sa right side, may nakita na tayong result ng P. Pero sabi ko nga, ang first step natin is, tingnan mo natin muna natin kung na-satisfy ba natin yung dalawang assumptions. So ang maganda po dito class kasi meron na siyang assumptions check na nasa lower right. Yung QQ plot, hindi ko to gets. So dito lang tayo sa dalawa, homogeneity and test. So unahin niyo po yung normality test. Okay, gaya nga ng sinabi ko, sa normality test, ayan, may tatlo na siya. Kasi yung sa kanina, yung clinical exploration Shapiro lang. Actually, dito sa tatlo, anong gusto niyong i-imply? So since it's less than 0.001. Ang 0.001 po natin, sinasabi niya na parang less than siya dun sa level of significance. Your level of significance here is 0.001. Okay? So since less than siya, ang ibig sabihin po niyan is hindi normally distributed ang data. Pero sabi ko nga for demo purposes, i-assume natin na normally distributed kasi gagamit tayo ng i-demo ko lang po yung paggamit ng parametric methods. So assume na lang natin na kunwari normally distributed siya. Okay? So again, pag ang value niya po ganito, usually ang conclusion po niyan is your data is not normally distributed. Okay, so after you check for normality, check po natin homogeneity test. Okay, sabi po kasi natin sa homogeneity test, pag normally distributed ang data, ang gagamitin natin is... okay, so wala. Anyway, sige, tingnan lang tayo dito. Levine's, let's use the Levine's. Okay, wala siyang Bartlett's. Anyway, ang sinasabi dito sa Bartlett's, tingnan nyo ha, 0.07 ang P. If our level of significance is 5%, okay, balikan nyo lang yun dun sa PowerPoint ko. Pag mas mataas ang p-value sa level of significance na 0.05, ang ibig sabihin po niyan, equal po ang variances natin. Okay? Pag equal ang variances natin, okay, pag equal ang variances natin, ang gagamitin po natin na t-test is the student's t-test. Pero pag ang kunwari lang po ano, ang lumabas na p-value dito sa Levine's is less than 0.05, ang assumption po niyan is, pag less than 0.05, ang assumption po niyan is, pag greater than, equal. Pag less than, ibig sabihin, hindi equal ang variances. So, pag hindi po equal ang variances, yung left side po natin, ikiklik po natin yung Welch. Okay? Ulitin ko lang ha. Ang Welch gagamitin natin pag hindi equal ang variances. Ang students, gagamitin po natin pag equal ang variances. So, since 0.07 is greater than 0.05, the level of significance, then equal po ang variances natin. So, gagamitin natin ang students. So, naka-check na po siya as default. Ayan. Okay? So, pwede nyo nang i-uncheck yung homogeneity kasi and normality kasi tapos na tayo dyan. So, usually yan ang first step natin na test the normality and then test the homogeneity test, homogeneity of variances. And then we proceed to the output of your t-test. So madali na lang, tingin tayo dito sa output. Ayan. Okay, so titingnan natin yung P. So ulitin lang natin yung decision rule. Sabi sa decision rule, makinig na lang po. Reject HO. So ang HO natin dito, what will be our HO here if you are comparing the behavioral score of men and women? Female and male. Sige, our HO would be, there's no difference in the behavioral score between male and female. HA alternative would be, there is difference on behavioral score between men and women. Okay, decision rule. Reject HO if alpha, let us assume that your alpha is 5%. Reject HO if 0.05 is greater than the p-value. Otherwise, accept HO. Ano po ang decision natin? Reject or accept? Ulitin ko lang. Reject HO if alpha 0.05 is greater than the p-value. Otherwise, accept HO. Sige, habang nagde-decide po kayo, kailangan din natin i-click yung descriptives para makita natin ano ba yung mean behavioral score ng men, mean behavioral score ng female. Ayan. So, makikita nyo na po dito. Okay, so ang mean behavioral score ng men is 51.4. Female, ang male naman is 46.1. Okay, may significant difference ba yung dalawa based on the value of your P, which is 0.07? Sige, do we reject or accept? Sige, anyone? Do we reject or do we accept?
Accept, ma'am.
Okay, so it's accept HO kasi your 0.05 is not greater than, it's actually less than the p-value. Okay? So when you accept, di ba, if you recall, our HO is equal ang behavioral score. So makikita nyo, ma'am, di ba mas mataas ang female? Hindi. Statistically, there's no significant difference. So we don't base it on the numerical differences. So we conclude that at 5% level of significance, there's no at 5% level of significance, it can be concluded that there's no difference on the behavioral score between female and male group. Okay, so ang gagawin nyo class sa activity ninyo, sige, bibigyan ko kayo ng sample. Kamukha ng ginawa natin dito sa... Okay, pakita ko lang ulit. Yun eh. Garo-arog lang po kayo nagigibunin do. Okay, when you conduct the computer sa hypothesis, may HO, HA, decision rule. Kung walang computed or critical, just show the p-value. And then decision, if accept or reject, and then the interpretation. Ayan, ito po ang gagawin nyo sa activity. Pero ang first step ko po dun sa instruction is, i-check nyo muna yung test of normality saka homogeneity test. Ayan, so let's go back to the movie. Ayan, so ganun lang class, okay? So importante na dito sa right side, kasi ilalagay nyo to sa appendix na part, andi dito po yung result ng t-test, tapos yung group descriptives. Okay, kung ano yung mean nung bawat group. And initially, di ba, yung nauna natin na ginawa is, we check, we interpret the homogeneity and the normality test. Kailangan din po yung output noon na ilalagay nyo sa appendix. Okay, kasi tinanggal ko na siya kanina. Okay, so this is independent sample t-test. Okay, what about, okay, the ANOVA? So let us demo how to apply the ANOVA. Ang ANOVA, di ba, comparing three or more groups of data. Take note, sa region natin, meron tayong tatlo. So, you have three groups. Ang types of behavior natin, we have four. So, you can actually either these two, if you want to compare the behavioral score according to region or according to types of behavior, we're going to apply the ANOVA because we're comparing three or more groups of data na. Okay? So, just click ANOVA and then one-way ANOVA. Ayan. Tapos, ipasok po natin ulit yung behavioral score sa dependent and then siguro we can use region. Ano po? Region sa grouping variable. Ayan. Actually, initially, may result na po siya dito sa baba. Ayan. 0.003. Pero sabi natin kanina, importante na makita natin descriptives. Ayan. Ang mean ng Calabarzon, 44.6. Ang Central Luzon, 46.7. Ang NCR is 57. Okay? So, yan. Parang initially sasabihin natin, ma'am, ang NCR ang may pinakamataas na behavioral score compared sa Calabarzon, saka Central. Baka may significant difference. Pero, tingnan muna natin assumptions check. Okay? So, punta tayo dito sa baba. Okay, normality test muna tayo. So, kanina nga sabi ko, di ba, hindi siya normally distributed, pero i-assume na lang natin na normal. Okay, pag ganito kasi hindi siya normally distributed. And then, pagtapos na tayo sa normality test, check natin homogeneity test. Okay, so ito yung sinasabi ko kanina. Since hindi siya normally distributed, pag normally distributed po kasi, ang gagamitin natin Bartlett's. Pag hindi naman normally distributed, ang gagamitin natin Levine's. Okay? Baka magtataka kayo, ma'am, pag hindi normally distributed, hindi pa pwedeng gumamit ng parametric. Ang ANOVA po kasi, analysis of variance, this is a robust test. Ibig sabihin po ng robust, minsan hindi siya sensitive sa normality ng data. So kahit na hindi siya normally distributed, basta quantitative siya, it already warrants the use of the parametric methods. Okay, so let's proceed. So assuming na hindi nga normally distributed ito, kasi magdedepende sa gagamitin natin homogeneity. So gagamitin natin dito is the Levine's test kasi nga hindi normally distributed. But look at the value of your p. Okay? The value of your p here sa Levine's is 0.002. And sabi natin sa homogeneity of variances, if p value is greater than 0.05, if p value is greater than 0.05, then we have your variances are equal. Pero pag hindi, your variances are not equal. Okay? So sabi dito, ang 0.002, that means ang assumption nito is ang variances natin are not equal. Okay? Not equal po ha, not equal. So kung not equal siya, check nito sa left side. Variances, naka-check na yun, don't assume equal. Okay? So yan na po yung ilalagay natin. Okay, naka-check na siya, hindi na natin siya papalitan. Pero pag kunwari ang lumabas po sa Levine's test, mas mataas sa 0.05, which concludes na there is homogeneity of variances, then we check the Fisher's. Okay? Yan. Pero since sabi nga natin, hindi equal ang variances, then we check this one. Naka-default na po siya sa don't assume equal Welch. Okay? So, yan. So, if you will be asked to interpret the normality and homogeneity, just export this one para mapakita nyo yun appendix, yun result ng homogeneity sa normality. Pero for now, tatanggalin ko siya. Natanggalin ko na siya kasi gusto ko mag-focus sa result ng ANOVA. Okay, so this is the result of the ANOVA. Okay, I will state again the decision rule. Reject. So, HO natin would be equal lang ang behavioral score among the three regions, Calabar Zone, Central Zone, and NCR. Alternative would be there is significant difference on behavioral score among these three regions. Okay, decision rule, reject HO if 0.05 is greater than p-value, otherwise accept. Ano po ang decision natin?
Accept.
Sige, sino pa yung iba? Ulitin ko ah, reject HO if 0.05 is greater than the p-value. Your p-value po is 0.003. Okay, let's decide.
Reject po.
Okay. Yan. So, reject HO.
Reject.
Okay, sige na, reject. Okay, so pag reject HO, ibig sabihin, may significant difference doon sa tatlo. Pero hindi natin alam, alin ba dito sa dalawa ang may significant difference? Kasi mas mataas ang Central Luzon sa Calabar Zone. Pwede bang may difference ba ang Central Luzon sa Calabar Zone? So, kailangan po natin mag-post hoc test. Okay? Okay, left part, i-click po natin post hoc. And then, since sabi dito sa post hoc, hindi po equal yung variances natin, unequal variances, okay, so we check itong Gaimes-Howell. Pero pag equal po, we check the two case. So, Gaimes-Howell po tayo. Yan, sige, interpret natin to ah. Yan. Wait lang, screenshot ko para mas malaki. Para alam natin pag-interpret ng... So, ito po yung mangyayari pala bukas kasi magpapanel ako sa limang students. So, yan. Lahat yan, yawn ako. Kaya po aning statistician sana. Okay, so... Iaano ko to para mas clear po sa inyo. Ayan. Papalakihin ko siya. Okay, so malapit na po tayong matapos. Don't worry. Mga 10 minutes na lang. Ayoko pa naman kayong ma-information overload. Okay, so how do we interpret the post hoc? Diba ang decision rule natin sa post hoc is may significant difference. Ayan.
Pero diba rin-reject?
Opo, reject nga po. Pag ni-reject po, may significant difference. Kasi ang HO po is equal ang behavioral score, HO. Since you reject, literally, you reject HO, your conclusion will be your alternative, which is may significant difference. But then you want to know which of the two regions here have significant differences. Okay, ayan. Okay po? Galit si ma'am. Okay, wait lang. O, sige, anong decision rule natin? Okay, so there is significant difference if 0.05 is greater than the p-value. Ganyan na lang. Tapos lalakihan natin. Okay, so by pair po kaya digdi ang ano, by pair po digdi ang pag-interpret. Ayan, sige, palakayin ko. Okay, so let's compare. Ayan. Okay, between okay, so between Calabar Zone and Central Luzon, titingin po kayo dun sa p-value. Between Calabar Zone and Central Luzon, it's 0.808 ang p-value. Sabi dito, may significant difference pag 0.05 is greater than the p-value. Okay, may significant difference po ba between Calabar Zone and Central Luzon?
Yes po.
Meron po.
Wala po. Kasi ang p-value natin is 0.808. Okay, balik kayo doon sa decision rule. May significant difference if 0.05 is greater than the p-value. Diba? Between Calabar Zone and Central Luzon, ang ano po natin is 0.808. Okay? Nagagets po?
Yes po.
Okay, so
yes po.
May difference po or wala? Calabar Zone and Central.
Calabar Zone, wala po.
Okay, wala po.
None
kasi
po. None po.
Okay. Between Calabar Zone and NCR, may significant difference po?
Yes po.
Yan, meron kasi.
Yes ma'am, yes.
Yan, kasi ang p-value niya is 0.003. 0.05 is greater than 0.003. Tapos, between Central Luzon and NCR, okay, is 0.014. Okay. Mas mataas po bang 0.05 sa 0.014?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. So, may difference between Central Luzon and NCR. Pero, balikan natin ang balikan po natin ang descriptives natin. Ay, sorry. Descriptives and then this one. Descriptives and yan. Okay? So, sa descriptives natin, yun. Sorry, ha. Ayan. Okay? Calabar Zone, 44.6. Central Luzon, 46.6. Eh, maliit lang naman. Walang difference between Calabar Zone and Central Luzon. Ang NCR ang may difference. Between NCR sa Calabar Zone, mas mataas ang behavioral score niya. Between NCR and Central Luzon, mas mataas ang behavioral score ng NCR. So, equal lang po ang Calabar Zone saka Central Luzon. Okay? So, that's how we interpret po the result of the post hoc test. So, may sample interpretation naman po ako dun sa PowerPoint. So, maging guide nyo na lang po yun if in doing your discussion. Okay? Ayan. So, okay? So, dito lang po, dinemo ko lang yung t-test sa one-way ANOVA kasi dun po sa activity niyo which I will be posting later, I will give this later, sa activity niyo po, ayan, Actually, ang i-apply nyo lang po dito, t-test, tapos t-test saka ANOVA. I'll be providing the data later. Okay? Yan. Kung may mga questions po dito sa instruction, PM na lang po ako or pwede pong i-post sa GC. So, this will be your data. This is your activity data. So, may mga iba't iba po ko tayo ditong, this time, job satisfaction. And then, you have your three variables here. Okay? So, you have job status, educational attainment, saka length of service. Ito po yung ginamit yung data last time. But this time, gagamitin lang po natin job satisfaction. Iko-compare natin job satisfaction ng gender between male and female. So, since you have two, nag-example na ako ngayon, you apply the t-test independent. And then, comparing the job status, job satisfaction along job status, educational attainment, and length of services, more than three groups po kasi, three or more groups po kasi ito. So, you're going to apply the ANOVA. Okay, so ang instruction po dito, i-check muna natin po yung normality of data sa homogeneity of variances noong job satisfaction na variable. And then, we proceed with the conduct of the complete test of hypothesis. Okay? Okay. So, again, this is recorded. Pag just in case po na you want to watch it again, then panoorin na lang kasi baka po may mga steps doon na hindi natin masyadong na-gets. Okay? So, I'll stop first my recording. I'll be providing you with a copy of this recorded lecture. Ayan.